Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to start lesson number 6 in English, and the name of the lesson is The Cactus, a Desert Plant. So, before starting the lesson, let us first see what is meant by the meaning of desert and cactus. Okay, so let's begin. A desert is a large area of land that has very little water and very few plants. Okay, so the place which has very little water and very few plants, that area is known as desert area. Can you see this picture? When lots of sand is there, very little water and very few plants are there, those area is known as desert region. Okay, now what is meant by cactus? Cactus means, let's see first. Can you name an animal that is called the sheep of the desert? So who is known as the sheep of the desert? Camel, because the camel can easily walk in the sand. That is why a camel is known as the sheep of desert. Okay, can you name a plant that grow in the desert and gives us fruit to eat? Okay, so find out which plant or tree grows in the desert region which gives us fruits to eat. Okay, now let's begin with the lesson. Cactus is a desert plant. Okay, so the plant that grows in desert region is known as cactus. So can you see here, there are various kind of cactus present over here. Okay, so these are the cactus plant. Okay, and these are mostly found in desert region. It is a plant that has no leaves, it has only fleshy stem. Okay, so this cactus plant, it has no leaves, okay, and it has only fleshy stems. Fleshy means thick and soft, and stem means the main long part of a plant above the ground. Can you see the main part of this plant that is above the ground? This is the ground, and above the ground, whatever the main part of the plant is, it is known as stem. Okay, so the stem is covered with prickly spine. Now, what is meant by prickly spine? Prickly spine means small, sharp, needle-like thorns on some plants. Okay, so spine means kata. Okay, so the stem is completely covered with spines. Okay, let's move forward. Then, cacti grow in desert and other dry places. So where this cactus plant grows, it grows in dry places like deserts. Okay, during the rainy season, their long roots take up moisture and store it in the stem. So during the rainy season, the roots of this cactus store all the water, okay, from the ground. It absorbs all the rain water and it stores for long period of time. Okay, these stems have thick hard walls, so the stem of the cactus is very thick. Okay, they are spongy inside, and the wall of this cactus is hard and thick. Okay, but inside the cactus, the inside thing is very soft like sponge. Okay, it is very spongy. On the outer side, they have a waxy coat. Now, what is meant by waxy? Waxy means looking or feeling like wax. Okay, wax means like sticky thing. Okay, so it has a waxy coating on its outer side. So the outer cover of the cactus is very, the wall is very hard and thick, and inside it is very soft, and the surface area is quite sticky like wax. Okay, it makes this plants waterproof. Okay, so as the coating is very sticky or waxy, and the wall is very hard. Okay, so this makes the cactus a waterproof plant. Okay, the cactus plant doesn't have any leaves. As you can see, there are only flowers and spines on the cactus. Okay, there are no leaves on the cactus plant. Okay, instead of leaves, they have spines. Spines means, as I told you earlier also, spines means kata or thorn. Okay, So each plant can have as many as 50,000 spines. So each cactus plants can have per plant can have 50,000, at least 50,000 spines. Okay, these spines save the plant from the desert animal. Now, why these spines are so useful for cactus? Because it saves themselves from the other animals that are surviving or living in the desert area. Okay, so since these are the spines means kata. Okay, so no animal can touch or eat this plant. Okay, then the cactus is curious looking plant. It is unlike any other plant. Some plant of this family are very tiny. Some grow 15 meters height. Okay, so this cactus plant are very different. Okay, it is very curious looking plant. Okay, so since these are different from all the other plants, some are very different. All these plants are very different from each other. Some are very tiny and some are very long. Okay, some can be very small and some can grow up to 15 meters of height. Okay, then in shape, these plants can have many different forms. So as you can see, the cactus plants can have different kind of shape. Okay, this is different from this plant, this is different from this plant, this is different from this plant. Okay, so these cactus plants can differ in size and shape and looks. Got it? Then they can be like trees, pipes, barrels, candles, hats, torches, caterpillar, or pieces of machinery. Okay, so all these are the examples of which a cactus can look alike. Okay, so the cactus can look like tree, pipe, barrels, candles, hat, torches, caterpillars, or pipes of machinery. Okay, pieces of machinery. Then Choya cactus has the most prickly spine. Okay, so the Choya cactus has most prickly spine. Okay, this spine come off so easily that they seem to jump at passerbys. So these spines are so can come off, means it can get off from the cactus plant so easily that whoever is passing by from nearby the cactus plant, it can jump on it. Those cactus spine can jump on the person who is passing by. Okay, pack rats pile up Choya stem at the entrance of their burrow. So what is meant by a pack rat? Pack rat is a large bushy tailed rat of North America. It has a rabbit habit of carrying of small articles to its nest. So what does this rat do? It picks up the Choya stems and it takes it to its burrow. Okay, burrow. Then it uses it to protect from the other animals. Okay, so the stem protect their homes from invaders. Who are the invaders? Invaders are those who attack or enter a place by force. Okay, so these rats protect their burrow from other insects or animals who can attack their homes. Okay, then a saguaro cactus is tall like a tree. It has branches that grows upward. So this saguaro cactus grows like a tree and the branches of this plant grows upward, means in the increasing direction. Okay, the stem is pleated like an accordion. So what is meant by accordion? Accordion is a musical instrument that has folds which when pressed produce sound. So the stem of the saguaro plant is like an accordion. Okay, it can store huge amount of water. So this saguaro plant can store lots of amount of water inside it. Okay, it produces white flowers followed by red flower. So this saguaro plants, cactus plant can have both white and red flowers. Okay, sorry, white flowers and red fruits. Okay, so a saguaro cactus can have white flowers and red colored fruit. Okay, A barrel character is fat and round in shape. Can you see this image? So this is the image of a barrel cactus. It is covered all over with spine. So all the sides of this barrel cactus is covered with spines. Spines means what? It means kata. Okay. Thousands of roots spread around the ground. So under the land, what is their roots? Okay, so there it can spread thousands of root inside the ground. The root absorb water and take it to the barrel above. So what does the root inside the land do? It absorbs the water and it supplies to all over the plant. Okay, like the saguaro, its sides stretch to store water. The sides shrinks as the water is used up. So what does the saguaro does is it absorbs the water from the land and it keeps it. It stores it for longer period of time, and as the water is used up, it shrinks. There are over 2000 type of cactus. Each type has special way to store water. So there are different kinds of cactus plant. There are about 2000 types of cactus plant, and it has its own way of storing water. Okay, so each cactus plant is different from other cactus plants. Okay.